Good evening, sports fans. And then there were two. Friday night, the Jenkins Warriors and the Richmond Hill Wildcats taking the field with the hopes of advancing to the Georgia High School Association State Championship games next week up in Atlanta. Two huge semifinal matchups. We're going to begin in AAA. Jenkins traveling down to Cordial for a Final Four showdown with Crisp County. Amy Zimmer and Rick Snow have team coverage from Cordial.
It was all about the defense tonight as the Jenkins Warriors took on the Crisp County Cougars in the GHSA Class AAA state semifinal. Jenkins looking to punch their ticket to the state championship for the first time since 1966. Warriors came out ready to put up a big fight. First quarter, Jenkins lights out on defense. Cougars quarterback shoots it out far left, but here comes Jenkins defense. Edward Osborne with the big tackle. This time, Cougars on the run. Warriors swarm. Cougars lose control of the ball. Dejon Morgan recovers for the Warriors to take over. Second quarter, still scoreless. Cougars in the pocket looking for an option with time, but picked off by Osborne, the senior, absolutely on fire tonight for the Warriors. Jenkins, Ronald Cooper III on the carry here, shakes and bakes for the big first down. Back-to-back face masks, moves the Warriors into the red zone. Damasio Harris punching it in for the Warriors to get on the board with the touchdown. Miss PAT makes it 6-0 Warriors at the half. However, the Cougars climb back ahead in the second half, up 14-6 with 1 minute left. Warriors go for it. Blake intended for Darius Bush, intercepted by Cougars to seal the deal. The Jenkins Warriors season comes to an end, losing 14-6 to Crisp County. Now we send it over to our own Rick Snow for post-game reaction.
That's a disappointing final score for the Warriors. It was a hard-fought game here in Cordial, but it's a game that will be appreciated maybe a little bit more down the road.
Bittersweet, you know, obviously because it ended like this, but at the same time, we're real proud of our kids. We're proud of our program, and I think we put Savannah football on the map a little bit. We're a defensive team. Like I said, Crisp County is almost identical to us. Like I said, you know, they just made one or two extra plays than we did. Our kids fought all night. I can't be more proud of our kids. I love these kids. I treat them like my own, and I truly believe they are. You know, we're a family. You know, we call it Warrior Nation, and that means that we're one family, and, you know, we fall to the end, and I'll continue to fight with these young men.
The Warriors end the season 12-2. It's a great record, but it's Crisp County going to the AAA state championship game next week at Georgia State. Back to you, Amy.
Thanks so much, Rick. Well, it's been an entertaining high school football season across Southeast Georgia and the Lowcountry. Unfortunately, tonight it came to an end just 1 week too soon. Reporting from Cordial, Amy Zimmer, WJCL 22 News.
All right, thanks, guys. Packed house in the Hill. Richmond Hill hosting Allatoona in the 6A semifinals. Visitors striking first in the first quarter. Buccaneers back to pass. Dante Marshall throws across the middle. Ball going to be tipped, then caught by Zach Johnson, who fights his way into the end zone for the touchdown. Allatoona goes up 7-0. The Richmond Hill defense going to settle in from there. Nathan Vickers going to come off the corner to register the sack for the Wildcats. That had the home crowd fired up, and you know what? So would this next play. Second quarter. Allatoona looking to throw again. Vickers applying the hit. Ball floats into the secondary where Gregory Freitman going to come up with the interception. He's also got the nice return, but it leads to no points for the Wildcats. However, later in the second quarter, following a blocked punt, Wildcats will find the end zone. Jalen Rouse from the Wildcat. He's in for the touchdown. Game tied at 7. Then it was more solid play from that Richmond Hill defense. The Allatoona pass going to be picked off by Kenyon Hunter, who lays out for the nice INT. The Wildcat offense comes back on the field, and they come up with a big play. Quarterback Tyler Coleman, he's going to air one out for Isaiah Allen, who goes up and makes the grab deep in Buccaneer territory. Moments later, Richmond Hill grabs their first lead of the game. How about the Tebow-like jump pass? Rouse to a wide-open Buckley Bayens. Wildcats grabbing a 14-7 lead at halftime after a scoreless third quarter. Allatoona on the move late in the fourth. Fourth down long, visitors are going to get the needed yards on this reception from Bennett Christian. Moments later, Allatoona throwing deep. Marshall going to connect with Asante Doss for the touchdown. This game, well, it was headed to overtime. After Richmond Hill would miss a field goal with their possession in OT, Allatoona, they're going to complete the comeback in this one. Jude Kelly, He is going to connect on the game-winning field goal for the Buccaneers. Heartbreak in the Hill. Richmond Hill falls to Altoona, 17-14, the final in overtime.
It's going to be a tough night for these guys, a tough pill to swallow. One step away, one kick away from going to the state championship game. I mean, goodness gracious, you never would have thought it would have been happening here at Richmond Hill, but our guys made it happen. I'm proud of them.
Congratulations to the Wildcats and the Warriors on outstanding seasons here in 2019. Don't forget the SEC championship game coming up Saturday in Atlanta, 4 o'clock kickoff. Georgia LSU will have a complete recap tomorrow night on WJCL 22 News at 11. That's a look at sports. Stick around.